Daniel Andrews has stopped short of apologising to the family of a 14-year-old girl who died waiting 30 minutes for an ambulance. The Premier's revealed he'd been briefed but has not read a critical report into the ailing 000 system. State political reporter Mark Santamartino.
Lydia Ann Celine died in her father's arms days after her 14th birthday and half an hour after being told help is on the way.
Try to be as strong as we can, but still don't understand, like, she's gone.
Dad Bernard and Mum Corrine telling A Current Affair their daughter's life would have been saved had they driven to hospital themselves.
Premier, do you finally take responsibility for the failings in our health system that has ultimately cost this girl and, sadly, a dozen others their lives?
I'm responsible, as every member of the government is, to make sure that we support our health professionals to do the very best that they can.
Daniel Andrews admitting he's been briefed but hasn't read a report completed weeks ago into the state's 000 system.
Why, after 15 people dying, why hasn't the report been released by the Andrews government as a matter of priority and urgency?
As a matter of priority and urgency, the Treasurer last week delivered a budget with the biggest boost to ESTA in its history. You don't even know what it's about.
Order.
And you're calling in, you're questioning me.
Order.
You're questioning me.
As ambulances ramped across the city last night, as many as 70 urgent patients were stuck on hold.
They're not stroke patients, they're not major traumas, they're general medical emergencies.
Ambulance Victoria declaring a code orange at 6:30 p.m.
We returned to business as usual over the course of about 2 hours. This is not a matter of not enough ambulances.
Even a minute feels like it's forever if it's your child that's, you know, short of breath.
How can you trust this guy to fix the mess when he's the one who has created it? You can't.
They can't follow health advice, but they want to run the health system. Really?
Attorney General Jacqueline Symes has committed to making that 000 report public by the middle of this year.
A lot of the items that are identified in that have been actioned. They're not open, they're not honest, they're not transparent. We need to see the extent of the problem.
And Mark, former Labor Minister Adam Somurek hasn't wasted an opportunity to slam the Premier.
He never does, Pete. There was a motion moved in the upper house this afternoon calling for the Premier to stand down after reports he's been quizzed in secret by anti-corruption investigators not once but twice. Now a vote shut that down faster than it was even raised, but not before Adam Somurek had this to say.
You can't have a Premier of a state being entangled in three separate corruption inquiries. IBAC is either devious, corrupt, stupid or incompetent.
The Premier has repeatedly refused to comment on anything his former minister says, Pete, or ongoing IBAC investigations.